That's just because fitness is a global phenomenon. It's not something which happens to one particular region or country or something. There are things that I won't talk about. I won't talk about yoga. So, to set your expectations right in the beginning.
You don't talk about
yoga.
Yeah.
It's nothing to do with fitness in my talk.
We are describing fitness, but that's not. Here, what my emphasis on is it takes a slightly different point of view on the way you should approach fitness. Okay. Usually, we see somebody very fit. We say, okay, I need to be fit. Or somebody has a medical condition, and so we need to do some better exercises, and that kind of kickstarts them. Or somebody wanted to run a race, and somebody started practicing. Somebody saw the nice gym in my office, and that's where they got started. Okay, but those are not the most interesting reasons why. Those are we can consider them as good starting points, but they are not the reasons. Okay. So something I'll focus on is like you and your body age profile. What women need to know. Most talks or books on fitness they talk about men, but that's again because the culture and the market, who are people who are buying the books, right? And I'll be spending about 20% time on that at least. So in sections where people don't know a lot of things, I like to highlight what lifestyle changes one needs to make, what kind of schedule you need to fit in a 30-day minute. Again, this 30-minute thing is not at only if you can do 30 minutes a day, you will be perfectly fine. But it's like a kind of pitching, right? You just say 500 times, why don't you listen to me? So it comes from that. And people are people think that if I need to go become fit, I need to go and join a gym. And that's the same reason. If I need to get to office, I need to buy a car. Reason is social, not scientific. Okay. But the important things are, what kind of exercises does one need to do? Should one join a gym or aerobic? How does one do proper exercises? What goes into building lean muscle? A lot of people you see will have nice, fairly decent arms. But what goes into making a lean muscle? And that's because you need to correct some of your age with the muscle. And that shows you where the focus should be. What aspects of nutrition do we need to focus on? What kind of food? It's very important. Injuries. Okay. Then what medicinal supplements are available? What protein and energy sources are available. So, I have brought some of this stuff, so you can actually take a look, you can even taste it. So, that's my idea about as far as supplements and nutritional stuff is concerned. I don't sell any of them, I don't endorse anything. Those are the ones I bring, are the ones I use. You may like it, you may use it, you may not want it, you want to buy something else. Okay. I have some type of body physical profile, and then the age profiles have defined something like this. So, 0 to 18, I have plus fat is kid. Split because of the different rates at which the body grows. 18 to 58 is what I consider the youth. Now it used to be like 18 to 28 or 18 to 30 is a youth. Even now a lot of people use it. But the reality is that the new 50s is becoming, the 50s is the new 30s. So people who are 55 are like 35s. That's because the consciousness that has come in people, at least in the West, not in the rest of the world. So if you look at Larry Ellison, he is perhaps the same age as a lot of people's grandfather. As an example, okay. 58 to 78 is what I call as people's accomplished. That's because if your investment between 18 to 58 is good, you roll very comfortably between 58 and 78. And if the investment in those 20 years is very good, you can roll to the next 30 years. And the last 30 years span, you see, I put it to 108, not 100. 100 is again something like, I don't know, that's a cricketing focus. But that's not the reality. I don't care. I don't even like it. But you will see a lot of people who are in Asia, especially China, very impressive, 100, 400, very normal. Japan. So longevity is now becoming an aspect of our life. Though we like to believe insurances. So, the other thing I want to highlight is that the same basic pool. Hi, welcome. The same basic pool exercises apply whether you are a fitness enthusiast. You want to do strength training, you want to be a power lifter, okay? You want to do bodybuilding. A lot of people think that when it comes to ex-fitness and bodybuilding, women have different requirements, but women is nothing can be farther from the roots. No difference. You'll not believe me, I know it. But this is an experiment that was done among women who were in their 90s in Sweden, a group of about 70 women who were living in what's called geriatric homes, because they're not staying with the kids. And they were incubated for 6 months. And they were found that in they did them into two groups. The groups which didn't do weights, and the other group did weights. Their breathing profile had improved. Those with respiratory issues, their cholesterol levels came down. Their overall fitness improved. And they had to be taken off certain medication which was prescribed for their age group. So people think like, okay, weight training I should do when I'm in 20s, but it helps you all over. I'll tell you what's the reason. And women can do exercises all the time, even when their periods are in session, it has no effect. There's something else to know about it. Just because there's an unfortunate term used in medical called occult blood. If you ever go for a medical check, this is occult blood. Occult is like a ridiculous term coming out of some medieval thinking. Reality, it means you're going to have a certain amount of blood loss. So 4 days, 5 days before that, if you go on a little higher dosage of iron and minerals, you just smoothly sail through. No issues. Okay? Women can and should do most of the exercises when they are pregnant. It's again a belief that women are pregnant, they need to be more comfortable and be in good thoughts. No. The good thoughts happen when your body is good, not the other way around. Okay? Exercising and sweating out just for 30 minutes per day is an excellent way for your body, cardio, distressing, and releasing endorphins. Endorphins are what gives you that good feeling. You'll feel tired, like you go to rock show, people will jerk themselves, right? In rock shows? And they feel, wow, I'm feeling good. Do you remember lyrics? Most people don't. So what are you feeling good about? I actually shook my body. So I must have sweated out, right? Strength training is progressive weightages. It's not like you pick up 10 kg first day and get started. And the other thing, important thing is, look at your hands. If you do something like this, you're moving a joint. You put in here, you're moving in a joint. So if you look at this, hips, this joint, this is extremely important. These are all called single joint, right? Because when you do any kind of activity, you're just touching on one single joint. But the other ones, like, so now you're using this, okay, you're doing something on the side. Again, so all of these are multi-joints. So if you're not getting stronger in multi-joint exercises, your training is not working. Okay, then your personal kit. What should go in? You're not going to the gym, this is your personal kit, just to get yourself, you know, kind of oriented towards looking things like a water bottle, shaker, cotton towel. Use most of the cotton stuff, because so that when it's cold or it is hot like these days, you will not get rashes. Because if you like sweat it out and then you do go and sit and then somebody's phone call comes and 25 minutes are done in that phone call, and then you say, okay, fine, I'll have a cup of tea, 45 minutes have gone. So a lot of people have sensitive skin, will get rashes. Okay. Please use innerwear which is V-shaped, especially for men, so that the testicular region is kind of held in place when you are doing something like this, okay, or any of these stuff like this, okay. So a lot of men actually who wear trunks, which are good for swimming, but not necessarily good when you're doing exercise or you're doing jogging, okay. Because you don't want your testicular things to hit the inner thigh when you're running in. And a lot of people get a little bit of swelling. Now that's not good. Because when you get a swelling, it will start, the pain will kind of come up into your abdomens, and then you won't do this exercise. This will become problematic. And this is called lunges actually. This is what actually gives you inner strength here and into your the portion of your hips. Okay? And if you can't do that well, you will not be able to, you will find a problem in standing. So a lot of people start standing like this. This is not correct. Standing is like, just stand straight. Okay? Cotton sock, okay. For women, please use sports bra or use something. I mean, I found Jockey to be quite good. I can't use it. But Jockey with side pads. Side pads are important because a lot of women are very careful. They will go later and wear something like swimming costumes and they'll see scratch marks. So, a good approach is use side pads. And if you notice stretch marks, please use something like shea butter. Shea butter with almond oil is an excellent way to get rid of stretch marks over here or into the belly region, especially people who have gone through a cesarean.
So the lining doesn't stay like a thin line, it kind of starts spreading and starts giving vertical cuts.
Cotton socks and canvas shoes.
And don't use flexi soles. Use air and all. Because the moment you start doing weights, that thing compresses. So your feet actually, your feet is not firmly on ground. And that can cause injuries. Okay? I have made those mistakes. Not on the shoes, but on the other sides. I'll talk about them. Okay?
But for running, canvas shoes gives blisters.
For running, canvas shoes is not a good idea. I would recommend something like this. I use this for running. Yeah. So this is actually thick sole, but it's firm. The second issue is with running is that, how do you run? So example, if I'm suppose you're running 5 kilometers, the typical thing is that you toe first,
heel first,
or it is heel first. Okay? My recommendation is don't do heels. Do toes. The reason we are not able to, because, okay, why you should do toes is because look at this. This is the ball. This is the ball of your feet, right? Now, when you hit, take out both of them and I'll feel the asymmetry. So when you put your both the balls, how you stand? This is how you stand. Right? Now there's a standing exercise which comes for your calves here. So if you do this exercise, it is called standing calf raise. What it will do is, it'll give you strength in this area, and the ball area will not get impacted. But with long running, what will happen, what will get impacted is your nails. So if you see my nails, you will notice what happens with long distance running. The nails break from the middle. Okay, the nails break from the middle. Look at this. So I do 10 kilometer morning, 10 kilometer evening on every Sunday. The casualty is the nail. Okay. Okay, so how much should one run? Some people like run marathon, fine, run it. The most optimal thing which comes to running is doing daily running to be 1 kilometer.
How much?
Daily running, but 1 kilometer.
Oh, 1 kilometer.
1 kilometer or two.
That's all?
Yeah, but daily. So when I say daily, it means 6 days a week at least. Now that's like, if you multiply with the whole year, that's a lot. So now with this thing background in mind, when you run, see how my fingers are responding when I'm trying to stand on my toes. So if I run, this. On the contrary, when I run on my heels, the heel hits and it gives a hit here. Then it gives a hit to my joint. So when the joint gets a hit, you see this portion? This portion? This way you start getting pains.
But with the ankle, with the toes, the ankle gets pain. I mean,
yeah, so
this
what
is the portion which hurts.
Yeah, so what happens is, it is again the posture. Like if I run like this, look at my face. My face is down, right? This is not the correct way to run. The way we run is, your vision should be absolutely parallel.
Okay.
So, okay. So it should be something like this. That you're looking absolutely parallel, okay? Your hands should be at this level. When you want to do running, your hands are at this level. So now you run. Like this. And everything is a spring, actually. You saw? Spring. So the spring effect, what happens, you feel like it's like that. And you slowly, gradually get to that. As if you run 1 kilometer, you won't even feel you ran 1 kilometer. Second thing is, please don't plug in. Because what happens then?
Yeah.
You get my point? So you will have more running and adjusting their earplugs than the running. And that causes shift in this, which means your one lung is stretched, one lung is will compress. They're not good.
But a lot of people around the world run with some music on.
Yes.
They got used to it.
Okay, so skipping rope is one thing that I recommend to everybody. I think I have one here. I'll take it. Yes. So I'd recommend something like this, or a rubber one, because it can be used to do multiple exercises. Okay. Another thing is, it's an excellent thing. Like you get in the morning and you want to do some stretches, right? But how do you do cardio? You're not planning to run, for example. You still want to do cardio. This is the best tool you have for cardio, and not that cardio machine in the gym. So all you do is just pick it up,
keep the same posture you are running and do something like that. Okay. So just go 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and continue. The result is, you notice what happens to your shoulders. So your shoulders are already stretched. And as you breathe, if you do something like 100, then you can move into like 120, 140, 160, 200. You will start getting more ability to breathe, and that improves the volume of your lungs. Once that improves the volume of your lungs, you will find that you can run even better when you run that 1 kilometer. Why? Because you are generating less lactic acid, given the fact you are inhaling more oxygen. So that makes a very big difference. Okay?
You recommend doing skipping
daily? Yes. Skipping is like, okay. In fact, why is it there in my bag? Can you guess? Because like, I'm doing some work and I get bored, start skipping. So two things that I do all the time is skipping and push-ups. It doesn't really cost you much to do a push-up. You don't need any major equipment, but you need a proper posture. So those are two things. So you do this, you like, people feel like, okay, I'm doing some work, I'm getting bored, what should I do? Okay, let me go and pick up a coffee or pick up a tea. This is a replacement for that. It is not a supplement, it's a replacement. Okay. Second thing to know is that if you've done the exercise, now you want to do a good little bit expansion to your chest. Because that gives you good feeling in the upper torso. Lot of us who will walk, we'll have excellent lower torsos. Okay. But as we are moving away from our older style of living, we are using less and less of our upper torso. So we don't any longer hang on the trees, we don't pull and jamun and eat for, you know, like you see in school. Schools don't have trees anymore, so kids can't go on them and hang around. Okay? So it all got very sanitized and clinically clean, right? So the other activity you need to do is focus on building the upper torso. This is very important for women and men both. Okay? In fact, as an observation, when more women were wearing saris, they had much straighter shoulders than they have now. As we are getting more other stuff, we do like this. Okay?
the muscle over here, the muscles that come in over here, they all get affected if you don't have a proper form. Okay? I'll give you one example of proper form. Like typically people have, like imagine this is actually bar metal, okay? It's not plastic, I just brought it, pulled down a rod. So what happens when you want to pick it? Most people will go and just pick like this. Now look at my back, look at my hips, look at my, and then I'm picking it like this. This is not correct. Because if you're picking some 1 kg, you won't feel it. You pick 10 kg, gone. So the first thing is, your spacing between the feet, same as your shoulder length, okay? Your knee bends, but before you can bend it, your chest should be straight, and then your hand, this is called pre-supinator, because you're gonna cup it and pull it up. The other way to pull it up is like this, okay? So you go in, now imagine you're trying to pick it. Okay, once you look down, now it's in your hands, because it's a little height, now you look straight. Now look at my back. Back has to be absolutely straight. Knee has to take the load. Then it has to come. Okay? And then if I now need to pick it, picking what people do, again my form is broken. The back cannot bend. If the back bends, if the back is not straight, you're gone. Now it's straight. So take in the air, because you're going to not put the effort. And then now you've got to keep it down. So again, the posture has to be maintained. If you don't take care of this portion of your back here, you'll get a pain. And believe me, this will be the most loyalest of pains you'll ever get. Do what after it will not go? As well, you've seen many gyms and many people tell you, put a belt and then do it. Because the purpose of belt is not to correct your posture, it's just providing extra support, because you're going to just screw up. So that's one thing to know. Another exercise which a lot of us like to do, but again there's an issue with the posture, is this one. So get yourself a mat like this. I had accidentally ended up in an Accenture session, so they were giving all the ladies this mat. I said, can I also have one? Yeah, sure. Okay, so a lot of people want to tighten up this portion. Okay, so,
crunches.
Sorry?
Crunches.
Yeah, crunches and abs. So, a common thing a lot of us do is, we want to do the exercise, we lie down, and then we pull us up. But you saw what happened when I was trying to lift up? My feet were lifting up. Don't do that. If that's what's happening, bring your hand onto your sides. And believe me, without the breathing, you will not get the benefit of the strength. Okay? The other thing is, a lot of people do is crunches. So again, note here, this portion has to become hardened. Before, you will not feel those pulls. So, if you're doing this, so can you come? Can you come and stand here? Now put your feet, put your shoes on my feet. Now just put it directly, no problem. No problem. Absolutely no problem. Just put it. Comfortably stand on it. Yeah. Right? Now, you need this support. Put your hand. This is one thing that makes it very easy with that support to be able to work on this. Okay? The end result of this will be that if you start doing this, okay, and then you later join in a gym, you can actually reduce this whole portion here.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
What is the alternative if you don't get support like that?
Okay. If you don't get support like that?
Like somewhere.
Something like that?
Something like that.
Right?
Almira is the best option.
Yeah. Yeah. But wear your shoes and do it. If you do without shoes, you might kind of graze yourself, right? And that's because the gain you will get is by doing more intense exercises. When you do intense exercises, it will start cutting you here. You need to cut this. And the result will be when you cut it, you can hit it yourself like without feeling anything. So that's extremely important. That's when this thing tightens, is when your bulge will go away. And all our muscles sort of kind of split. The ones here, they should kind of split in between. When you start, getting into better shape. So that's something you need to take care of.
So how do you choose, sorry, I came in the middle, breathing, you mentioned about breathing. How do we know when to inhale, when to exhale?
Very simple, EOE. It's a typical...
Did you already cover it or?
I mentioned before, but yeah, I mean effort on exhale on effort. So EOE is exhale on effort. In position, should I do it when I'm going up or when I'm going down? No. The idea is very simple. You exhale when you're feeling you're putting the effort. Like you're putting I was picking this up, right? So now, this is my effort.
So exhale.
Yeah. Right, so that is exhale on effort. And then there are exercises which are kind of classified so which focus area should be like, we want to do strengths or other things. For each of them there are different exercises. There's huge number of sets actually. But the ones I showed you are the ones that are like, you must do them every day. Squats, okay, crunches, abs, stretches, and lunges. Lunges are very important because they'll give you strength to your hamstring and they're like, again, okay. And another thing which you can do even in office, anywhere, is strengthen, do lunges. How lunges are done? Typically, we think this is not the finished form. This is the start. Okay? If you're feeling uncomfortable, just do your hands like this. And bring your head. Then, this completes it. When you stretch it, make sure this is coming at 90 degrees. It's like perpendicular to the ground. And then you do this. Three steps back. Similarly. And this is difficult. Back lunges. That's how the whole thing is completed. This gives you good tightening on these. So when you run, your feet stretches, leg stretches, lunges provide a good support on your hamstrings. The squats, absolutely straight back, looks parallel, go down. So this is the exercise. Okay. A lot of exercises that I have. Agility and blah blah blah. So I'll focus on something else. Okay, so the other part I want to focus on lifestyle changes.
Maybe that's where we kind of sort of.
Five pure lifestyle choices. They affect your fitness dramatically. If you want to make one change, okay, I'll just tell you my story in 30 seconds. When I graduated, I was like 75. After my second job, I was like 90. After my fourth job, I was like 106. 2 years ago, I became 56. Now I'm 66.4.
So any illness or how did you lose that much? 100 to 55 is like half.
Just this. In fact, I never did any exercise.
I can kill for that.
This is what I did. Anybody ask me secret, this is what I tell. And amazingly, it's worked for me. I can't tell the formula, this is the formula.
But how do you have a choice on the stress?
Okay.
Purely choice.
This is the way you deal with the stress. This is how it worked for me always. It works for me. This is the only way it works.
Sethi, you're running out.
Yeah. I think I've run out of time.
Yeah.
So I'll just finish this and just be over, okay?
Yeah, sure.
So if you can get, you make sure you don't eat salt, no oil, no sugar. We're taken care of.
But isn't salt important?
Yes, it is important. And what is more important to know is that if you even once eat out in the day, and that includes eating in your office, you get more salt than you need for next 2 days. So you don't have to put salt in what you...
So no smoking, no alcohol, no salt, no oil, no sugar.
No, just by the way, when I say no sugar, alcohol is included.
So salt, which part of salt
are you
referring to? Sodium.
Okay, what's the problem? When you have more sodium, it actually, sodium traps water into your cells. Your cells get puffed up. You start having other kind of cravings and stuff like that.
But won't you get dehydrated?
You will not.
Drink water.
Sorry? Drink water.
One quick question.
Yeah.
Do you recommend nutritional supplements? Do you think?
I have a lot of them, but I think I'll have to talk
about them at the outside thing, because I am carrying with them. You guys should take a look at them.
We have like half an hour break now, 10:30 to 11.
So we'll continue.
So can
you?
I don't think
want to sit here and continue.
Oh, fine. Oh, excellent. Okay, so I want to tell, I'm telling you everything from a personal experience. I'm not trying to read a book and tell you, okay, this is what you should do. For example, if you are not dating anybody, please start dating. You'll find your stress level will come down by 50%.
It will go up.
You know,
I disagree.
Where do we get them inside to hit someone?
Sorry?
That's not true. In fact, you should date two or three people.
Perfect.
Oh.
Perfect. Yeah, because
right.
The result of that will be you'll become shallow and democratic. That won't be.
So that's not the topic here, right?
Right.
I have a question.
Yeah.
How about like eating like stone salt, not the free for
no salt. No salt.
No, which is actually I heard that is better than using the.
You'll have to check some expert. I will make no statement about that. Okay. Next. This is an important thing that happens in office all the time. Accept the offer of coffee and then offer the coffee back. I'm so interested in listening to you. Why don't you drink my coffee?
Okay, how many coffee do you take? Like two, one?
No coffee.
Without sugar?
My argument against coffee is very simple. I could be wrong. My argument is when you will eat all the supplements, you'll eat all these minerals, you'll eat all the fruits. Now all minerals and all good things that happen in your body. When you drink coffee will leach it out of your body.
Tea?
What green tea and
green tea.
What is written here?
I don't know.
Drink water, green tea.
Green tea is horrible.
Or red wine. To stop beer and extract red.
Drinking healthy. Dry leaves.
I can accept that.
Red wine.
Next one.
Silicon
cyanide. Poisonous. Your friendship can start, you can tweak your friendships. Use a toilet N+2, N-2. So if you stay in your office in some tower in level, say 4, whenever you want to go for a loo break, please go for 6th floor or go for 4th floor. The result is, and when you have to go up, please run. When you come down, you'll walk. And when you're going down, please walk and then run back. Okay? Learn Bharatanatyam. Ditch the Ralpal, learn the steps. Now, a lot of people think, okay, it is only religious. No, it's not. Just focus on the steps, you learn it better. Learn Zumba. Zumba is fairly active dance. Learn salsa. Okay, this is for guys and girls both. Masturbate more often. This is one of the finest ways of de-stressing yourself. Okay. In fact, you will not believe, but in UK, this is actually recommended in schools. It's a policy in schools.
But you know, if you see the older scriptures, etc., they say you need to preserve the fluid, right?
I don't care about any scripture.
No. What I mean is that this probably is there any.
Okay.
This is a totally
off the session, because it will cause us to have a conflict on that issue. Okay. Okay. But the reality of this is, if you're doing bodybuilding, you'll gain majorly, because bodybuilding, the muscles built in your body as a result of testosterone. A good way to, and by the way, testosterone is produced by men and. And women. Yeah, so difference is like if men will produce something like 5 microgram per deciliter, women will produce 2 microgram per deciliter. But it is the building block for your muscles.
It's okay.
Okay.
No, I'm just wanting to say that there is tea and coffee available.
Fine. Those of you who have partners or married or whatever, make love not babies, have more non-clitoral sex, it will bring down your stress level dramatically. The key point with stress is, it is in the mind. The stress is not outside. In fact, my favorite punchline is stress is an inside job. It is. Okay, what it means is, it's somewhere running inside here. Of what he will be judging me after he has seen this slide written with all his A+ stuff. That's what generates the stress here. Or what will I look like in front of the manager because I said something about him or I praised him. Wash your car and bike. It'll take your mind off. The thing is, a lot of activities which involve a little bit of physical work, we kind of disconnect ourselves by giving a very smooth argument. I could save some time. Okay? Use your washing machine to soak and swirl the clothes, but wash and rinse them manually. So what it means is, alright, I got some clothes here. So now imagine that my jeans was kind of washed into the, sorry,
into the washing machine. But now when it's wet, people put it into spin, right, to dry? But take it into your hand. Look at this exercise. What are you doing? You're working the muscle. Keep your back straight, rinse. You need to do the same thing in the gym. You're doing it in your jeans. Okay? Another thing about posture. Get a chopper board and chop carrot, onions, vegetable, fish, fillet with a straight back. Now what are you doing? Look at your back. Depending on right-handed or left-handed. Very, very simple lifestyle choices if you make, you'll get 50%, I would say 100% better than if you're not exercising. From your current state, you get 100% gain on this. Then you start doing exercising. Once you gain on the exercises, then you move on to aerobics. Once you do that, then you move on to gym. So it's like a progression. Okay? I gain and I move ahead.
Excuse me, guys, there's an announcement. Tea and coffee has been arranged.
Sure.
Thank you.
Okay. Then, get a check on four medical conditions, irrespective of your age. It can happen anytime. Abnormal cholesterol level. All right? A very interesting thing happens. If you're stressed and if you're a lady, you're 22-year-old, your mens will shift by a cycle, by at least one cycle. Okay? If you were dating somebody and fooling off with a guy, you'll feel like, oh, I got pregnant. Not true. Stress did it. As an example. Okay? High or fluctuating blood pressure. A lot of people think of high blood pressure, but what is fluctuating blood pressure? It goes down. After some time, something happens, it comes up. That's another issue. Okay? Third is diabetes, chicory, abdominal obesity. If one form of obesity I'm against is abdominal obesity. Because it is the building block, it is the source for almost all other issues that you will get. Okay? Increase fiber intake, don't eat Quakers, please. Okay? You can take steel cut oats, okay? Flax seeds, bird feed, you'll get tons in the market, like 12 rupees kg. Because anyway, you're going to spread it and throw it on the birds, no? Put it into pressure cooker, put a bit of zira. Yeah, and eat it. In fact, in the US it's called quinoa. Bob's Red Mill, if you try to use Bob's Red Mill's quinoa, comes out perfect, and bulgur wheat. Okay? Brown rice and whole wheat. Whole wheat is not your Ashirwad atta. It has no blessings for you. Okay? This is what you need to get a diagnostic on. BMI, simple, you can do it yourself. Otherwise, you go to Forum Mall, one 5 rupee coin pop, you'll get your BMI. BMD is like a bone mineral density, do for spine and femur. Especially if you're a lady and who's had a pregnancy, maybe say a year ago, get a BMD done for your femur and for your spine. Another reason why I mention spine is because those of the women who undergo what's called as cesarean. I don't know if you've seen a cesarean operation, but you will notice actually they are made to sit. Okay. All right. Then an anesthetist and a helper comes and actually puts his legs on her back and makes her fully bend like this, and then injects here the anesthesia. Okay, so that when later they'll make a cut here, there'll be no pain. But this has a debilitating effect onto the lower back of a woman, which is paid many times over than a normal canal-based birth. Right? So you need to get a diagnostic on that. So, okay, a lipid profile, and if you have say elevated lipid, please do a C-reactive protein and an ECG. So one time you're cleared off. Okay. Otherwise, many times people say, I'm jogging. I'm feeling a little bit of an uneasiness here. It could be because you slept in one posture, or it could be because you're having mild angina. Dental health. The only thing I want to tell about dental health is that it's not necessary to brush your teeth.
What?
It is not necessary to brush your teeth.
Then how will you date?
Let me check if I have it in the back. Oh no. Sorry.
Floss.
So you can use that old, now it comes in market as miswak. You can do that. But the key thing is what is between the gaps of your teeth. So you have this dental floss that is not available in Auchan. It is not available in Big Bazaar. It's not available in Moore or Spencer or wherever. But that's a real thing.
Floss.
Yeah.
It's available in Health and Glow.
Health and Glow. So you just do that in your teeth, you'll find a lot of small things come out and you'll get a better breath in your ear than Listerine. Okay. Hemogram. Okay, you want to check how is your hemoglobin level, both men and women, uric. A lot of people don't realize, but a lot of issues they face is because of higher homocysteine level and they will notice it by noticing that their nails have become a little thicker, especially the thumbnails. If that's what's happening, then you have a uric problem. It can be dealt very simply. So women who go, this is for men, okay? Most men suffer from uric problem. It's also called gout, okay? But the solution for that is to take something which pregnant women are recommended. All pregnant women typically take something, a medicine called Folvit. It's a folic acid supplement. So that when the baby, in the first trimester, the nuchal membrane that will develop properly. Now the same thing if men take, it helps them improve two things, sperm count, and second thing is, they get homocysteine level is managed. Okay? Another thing is, cross your legs while standing, so this is another type of exercise. Okay, you can do it anytime. By listening to anybody, somebody's giving you a long lecture, you know how it was, and how it was, sure, tell me, yeah, I was doing it. So keep doing it. And then after starts, when he starts, when he's going overtime, start doing fast. Yeah. Okay? So first slowly, then rhythmically. This is what people do in dance all the time. It's a dance step. Okay? And then, if suppose your husband or wife or partner has come, don't go to Luma, he has come. You open the door, go ting tong happen. Shake like some, yeah, you have to. I'll open that door. Right? So these kind of small changes will actually make a change to your mind. Okay? Then daily goal chhar MFS style. Do something which you're passionate about every day. You want to write a blog? I will write, but I have to make that call. Don't take that call, switch off the phone. Bol battery charge karo. And get going. Switch off that refrigerator. This I did, it took me some time, but I have done. Whatever you will take home will not work, because take home feature got disabled. If fridge is not on, where will you keep what you got? How do you have to finish it by next morning? Cake and ice cream are gone to the neighbor's fridge. In fact, what I saw about, learnt about lifestyle is that your current problems are lack of thoughtfulness. Haan, bolo. And I'm on the phone and I'm eating pizza. I don't know how much pizza I eat. This is exactly what happens when you go for a company party, right? Sir, please give me your plate. The moment your plate is taken off, you don't remember how much you ate. Otherwise, you have to keep the thing on the plate, right? That's what you do in the restaurant when you go for a party. So, one possible lifestyle schedule is something like this you can make. At 6 o'clock, get up, have apple and water.
6 o'clock?
I mean, this is a possible schedule, right? You can tailor it. 7:30, have some complex carbs. So, when I say complex carbs, if you want to really munch on something, munch on this. Again, I don't recommend the product, but yeah. Yeah. So, munch on this. Anybody can want to taste? Can taste? Welcome. You see. So, it's like a mixture, but it's not Lakshmi Ram Chuda. Okay, you can taste it if you like.
It actually
tastes
good, very good.
Sorry? Yeah. So, before being in Bangalore, I was in Pune, so I used to eat all the same LNC. Okay, and so they're like, oh. And cutting chair. Okay.
Must cover.
Yeah. So, complex carbs and boiled eggs. When I say boiled eggs, it means eat the whites, leave the yolk. Okay? So, in a day, you can easily eat 10 boiled eggs, no issues. 3 plus 3 plus 4.
But I can have 1 yolk a day, right?
Yeah, you can have. In fact, you should have yolk because that'll give you beautiful, nice hair. So all the men who are women who are having a slight whitening of the hair, you need lecithin. Lecithin comes out of your egg yolk. Okay. 10:30 have banana plus milk or nuts or protein shake. Okay. So again, question is, what kind of protein shake I can take? So one of the ones I found is very good for me is egg and whey.
Venkis.
Shri Venkateshwara Hatcheries. So you can again taste it.
You get it in Bangalore?
Yes, Trim Life. I bought it from Timbaland. You can get it from Health Card. It's very cheap.
So it's not a health and glow. Next year,
no. It's actually like a honey powder.
I don't take protein.
But it's not soluble in water. So the way you do it, you remember this long, tall glasses that you get with a cap? Take a spoon of it, or four teaspoons of it, put some cold milk, shake it. And you get a delicious smoothie because it comes in, like, say, this is like in mango flavor, and also in chocolate flavor, and stuff like that. So. Any of you want to try out? Most of them. Well, I got the stuff which is there in my.
So, Pune based brand,
thank you. It's India based.
It's India based.
Yeah. Okay. There are also the ones who bought off, I think, Manchester United?
Huh?
Oh, no. So, one of the.
Blackburn Rovers.
Huh?
Blackburn Rovers.
Okay. Perfect. So, they bought some football club, right? So, again, 12:30, complex carbs, chicken or beef. Most of the supplements that I have to show you, they all come out of meat. So, if you eat mutton, great. Lean cuts. Lean cuts means essentially the fat part is not there. That takes care. If you eat
vegetarians,
supplement.
Chickpeas.
There are a lot of stuff. You can read books. I can. I have listed out books. You can take a look at those books and see what you can eat, especially for your condition or vegetarian. I put as arthritis, vegetarian, whatever, because there's restriction. You're going to put a restriction yourself. Okay, so.
But mutton and all are good for heart and all.
Pardon? Okay, what I mean to say is lean cuts. There's a difference between normal meat. Okay, for example, I have eaten chicken. Does it mean you eat whole chicken? No. It means chicken without the skin, and don't eat the leg pieces. Eat the chicken breast, because that is the leanest. Okay. The other reason why I mentioned it like this is because I want to emphasize the fact, and that is people must eat clean. What we eat a thali. Right? When I mean clean, suppose you're eating a 12-30 complex carbs. Complex carb means whole wheat roti or brown rice. And you have two pieces of chicken. That's it. And then kind of close it with one roll-in of curd. Okay? 15-30, fruit juice or nuts. So you take maybe walnuts or... no peanuts, okay? Walnuts, almonds, very good. Pistachio, and have some fruit juice, or fruits. And interestingly, I found out fruits juice was that a guy was selling juice, pineapple juice for 20 rupees. I said, okay, fine. Give me pineapple juice for 20 rupees. I'll just take the pieces of pineapple that you'll put into that container. So that way, you get to eat the pre-cut pieces and eat them. Then 17-30, pineapple, avocado. Avocado sandwiches, a lot of us know it has butter fruit. It is delicious. You can take your normal brown bread, apply it in that and eat it. Delicious, super. You can carry it for lunch. You eat two sets, full.
In this fruit juice, you know, there's a recent fad by which the way it is cut, there are different kind of mixers. Does that actually,
I have no idea. I just buy a fruit, cut it, eat it. If I go to shop, I have no choice but to drink a juice. I'll tell him.
I was kind of surprised to know to see that you know the way you make the fruit juice by the way you use the mixer that itself affects the calorie count.
Possible, but I just eat the fruit.
And one thing about making fruit juice is it'll add a lot of sugar.
Yeah. So by telling him that you're not putting sugar, you're saying making more money. He's very happy to give you those pieces. Okay. Into the thermocol plate or something. Mm-hmm. The 90-30 chicken or beef or 6 boiled eggs. No carb. If you want to lose. And tight fat and tighten up your body. You notice after 12:30, effectively you have gone out of complex carbs. So eventually, see, have proteins. Protein is what your body needs to build lean muscle. So you must eat lean proteins, and you must eat only protein at that time. Okay, fruit salad. So for example, if you don't want to eat any of this, have a protein shake at 7:30. Okay, you will get 3.5% fat coming out of casein. That's okay. 8:30 or something, have fruit, but after this, don't eat. Okay. So this is in this couple of things I want to mention is glute side. This portion is called the glutes. So this should be tightened up. Okay. So when you want to exercise, this should be tight, and this is what supports your lower back. Absolutely essential. You will reach this if you're not taking care of your form very soon. And this is the reason why people go to gym, take that membership on attractive terms, and that's the end of it. Because once an injury comes, you will have to bring down yourself. The purpose of joining a gym is to do weight training. What is the benefit of weight training as against in aerobics? In aerobics, you're able to exercise the body. You're able to stretch it. Okay, you're able to bring coordination, agility, and those kind of stuff. But if you see a typical... listen, I'll do with my feet. Suppose I'm doing on this joint exercise the weights, okay? Like a, for example, this is an exercise called good morning. It's typically done for your back. So something like this, imagine this is a barbell, okay? And then I'll do. This is very good for your lower back, for example, this exercise.
When you're doing that, can you go back?
You shouldn't go back like this. No. If you want to go back, then don't do weights. The purpose of weight is that you actually flex in. Hi. Why don't you take a seat? The purpose
for
of.
For the next session,
yeah, that will be 11th.
No, we are here
for this. All right. Welcome. Okay.
You have 5 minutes.
The purpose of. Yeah?
You have 5 minutes.
Okay. The purpose of isometrics is you actually lock the posture of the joint. For example, if you do hands. Okay. So let's do hands quickly. So suppose this was the same thing I was doing in hands. So now look at this. It's in my hands. So now if you see, the joint is not moving, but at the joint I'm putting that weight. This is what gives me that extra weightage when I do. Now see, I did this is what biceps, right? Right? Now I do the same thing onto tricep, but now I'm doing say a tricep kickback, in which my posture is, imagine I have a dumbbell in the hand and I'm doing like this. So what will happen? This portion of the muscle is now. So this the purpose of isometrics is to take a particular muscle group and tear it. So muscle building happens as a result of tearing. So when you do, you have a expansion phase and you have a contraction phase. The contraction breaks it. And that's when the muscle tear happens. So the muscle elongates. You drink, so for example, protein shake, you're doing workouts, or you're doing, you've done this 10 kilometer run or 5 kilometer run and then you've done the exercise. The moment you're done with your exercise and you come back, drink a protein shake. That's the best time. It'll actually go and sit into your muscles and you'll build maximum muscles. At any other time you drink, your body is, because you have done the exercise, your BMR, your basal metabolic rate is much higher. Okay? So that is the way. And most of these, like protein shakes, the ones which are come at higher end, like On Nutrition, Muscle Tech, and Pure Whey, or Creatine Isolate, they also have something called BCAA, which is branch chained amino acids. So these are like purified stuff. Eat it, it just goes directly into your muscle. But within 15 minutes of doing your exercise. So come back, wash your hands, dab yourself, and take the protein shake. Okay? I think now I'm almost towards. Then I have a lot of exercises, but that's okay. Then, okay, just one thing you mentioned here is most people think I'll go to the gym and I'll do the exercise, but look at the schedule CBL, STB. So for Monday, I'll do the chest. On Tuesday, I will do the biceps. On Wednesday, I will do the legs. But the day I do the legs, I don't do the abs. So automatically, my exercise related to abs and crunches shouldn't be done. Otherwise, I'll get a pain here. Because there are exercises in related to legs which you do, in which you take weights on your legs and you press it out. So most of the exercises are press exercises. So as well, your this muscle over here, you will pull that ligament. And then if you get a sprain here, or you get a sprain here, it will be your loyal friend for a long time. Okay? Then you have shoulder, then triceps, and then back. The day you do back, the day you do legs, no abs. Okay, so those are the sort of small things. No? And then... Okay. So how do you get injuries? The places you get injuries are in joints and muscles, mostly connective tissues. So three main sources of training injuries are bad exercises, overtrainings, or good exercises done poorly. You're doing exercise perfectly, but you want to increase your reps. When people start doing this, they start injuring one of the joints. And most of them will be asymmetric, right? Some of us are right-handed, so our left-handed will be. I'm like right, left-handed, so my right hand will be, so I get injuries on my right side. So. Then nutrition data. So you can see how much calcium you need, how much copper you need, chromium, fat, folate, iron, magnesium, protein, riboflavin, selenium, vitamin B12, vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K, zinc, and phytochemicals. So a lot of protein supplements become available in the market. Let me see if I get it. So, I have a bunch of okay. So I should mention here one thing. A lot of people, when they will do exercise, they'll start using this kind of stuff. They will either use these gloves or they will start using bandages. My recommendation is if you don't do anything, use a crepe bandage. This gives you better control. And if you want to be really the classic guy, buy some of that chalk powder. But a lot of us, like for example, I have a problem on my right wrist, so this is very helpful. I can, for example, apply iodex, wrap around, and there's a very simple wrapping technique which I could kind of share with you. Just do a roll on the joint, 2, 3, 4, and then bring it here, because this is where the barbell will come. 2, 3, bring it back and kind of notch it in. Now you got a support. So you got a support here. Instead of somebody holding it for you, now you got a support. Now you can easily. And also the corrugations on the bar will not cut your. But you know, people get these marks here. That's a good thing. You can always use pumice stone, which we use for cleaning up our feet, to clean up for that. Okay, last. Okay, these are the books. If you are doing exercises, stretching, go for, this is a book called Total Fitness by Nita Martin. If you want to look at all aspects of nutrition, which veg stuff, which non-veg stuff I want to have, look at Human Nutrition, it's called the former Heinz Book of Nutrition by Benjamin Burton. All right, there's one segment which is not here, but I still have them as my audience. I would love to have them. Are people above 60s. For them, there's this fantastic book called Keep Fit for Life, which targets people above 60. It's published by World Health Organization. Then, two things which I see very common, people having arthritis. Not necessarily because their parents had arthritis, but because they got inflammation so much, they got arthritis. So, Eat to Beat Arthritis and 30 Minutes to Healthy Heart by Sheena Meredith. Right? I would recommend low carb cooking for health, then go for kitchen doctor. You can copy this from me, or I'll give you our cards, just drop me an email, I'll send you. This is just a simple text file, right? Nothing great.
You can just put them in your session list.
Sorry? Yeah.
You can just put them in the session list.
And of course, all the information I collected couldn't have come from just reading. So there are people who actually talked over a period of time. So Dr. Francis Mercola, whom I met in San Jose, is an amazing guy. Dr. Savita Devi, who's in Hyderabad, and Dr. Zohar Khan, who practices nutrition. Dr. Arun Kinare is a radiologist, so he looks at a lot of ultrasound scans. He's based out of Pune. Dr. Hema Devakar is a very famous surgeon in Bangalore. She's out of JP Nagar. Dr. Rahul Malashtey is again in Pune. Then there are ladies whom I've had very good and close discussions because I cannot bring out so much information without knowing. So Namita, Sean, a lot of my friends are from China. So because I wanted to learn what they have done because they have amazing bodies. So and how they can continue to be fit and look slim and still be able to do a lot of stuff with stamina. So Caroline Tang and Pine Pan, and some of my gym partners, friends whom I meet in the gym all the time, Deepak, Azim recently won the Bangalore University Bodybuilding Championship, and Balaji. Because one thing which you need in the gym is, when I'm doing this and I'm on my fifth rep and I'm getting stuck, I just need somebody to just give me a little bit of nudge so that I can complete this. So I do that for Balaji, Balaji does it for me.
Gym buddy. Gym buddy.
Yeah. Though I don't talk to most people in the gym because I want to focus on my exercise ranking. So that's all that's there to it. If you have any, I'm just write down here so it's easy for me and easy for you guys. So I'm Sefi at sina.cn.com. If you have a question anytime, 948290352. And if you're on Facebook and you want to link up, then sefi.creators.
Great, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. So I guess that's all I have to say. And if anytime you want to come out, go around for a job or just want to chat or want to do, you want to set up a gym, I'm trying to set up a gym at my place. So let's just link up and exchange. You want to go for a job sometime? Guys or girls, anybody? Fine, we can meet at some common place and go for a gym together or go for a job together. So 10K off.